If you're a serious creative professional in the movie industry, 3D animation, game design and such, you'll soon realize that a consumer desktop, even when powered with a 16-core beast like the Ryzen 9 5950X, is barely enough. A couple of months back, we did a review on the brand new AMD Threadripper Pro platform, but I did say that we lacked the equipment to fully demonstrate its potential as a workstation platform, because we're not pro enough. Which is why today, in collaboration with someone who is even more pro, we are gonna teach you everything you need to know about the difference between a consumer desktop and a proper workstation. Your mother no teach, I teach you la! Also, we're gonna be cramming in as many RTX 3080s as we can, because we can. Hashtag Malaysia boleh. In the past few years, the line between a workstation and consumer desktop PC has blurred, especially when it comes to the creative industry. Back in the day, DIY gaming PCs or white boxes was only meant for low-budget artists or studios. Yeah. But with the release of desktop CPUs like AMD's Ryzen or Threadripper lineup, not only can you now build a PC that is very strong when it comes to single-threaded tasks like gaming, you can also get CPUs with 16 cores and more. These high core count CPUs are now made available at a much more affordable price point for the general consumer, striking the perfect balance between work and play, especially for content creators like me. Joe, then why is AMD launching a new processor called the Threadripper Pro, as well as a new chipset, the WRX80, meant specifically for workstations? What makes a workstation, well, a workstation, and how is it different from your regular consumer PC? To learn more, I decided to call out my friend and also fellow YouTuber in Malaysia, Mike Brown from Mediaman Studio Services, to actually deck out our Threadripper Pro workstation with all the specs and also run some benchmarks to show us what a true workstation looks like.
Hi Shane, thanks for reaching out to me. I also get this question a lot from the viewers on the Mediaman Studio Review channel. What is a workstation and who should be purchasing one? I've worked in animation in the visual effects industries for about 25 years for some of the world's largest studios like ILM, Lucas Animation, DreamWorks, as well as a project for Warner Brothers. So the first thing I tell anybody when they're looking for a system to create content for any form of delivery, be it YouTube or a Hollywood movie, is a desktop computer is more than capable of creating compelling content, but a desktop computer does have its limitations. So these limitations are the number of CPU cores available in a desktop CPU, the quantity of RAM or memory channels offered by the motherboard, the number of PCIe lanes that can communicate directly with the CPU, and the ability to upgrade in the future if your production grows.
So just like Mike said, when you're dealing with creative workloads with desktop PCs, you're gonna run into some limitations. And the first one is CPU cores. Now on a desktop CPU, you can go up to 16 cores, and that seemed like a lot, but if you're dealing with much heavier workloads and you want more cores, you cannot already with a desktop PC. But a workstation platform like Threadripper Pro, you can go up to 64 cores with the Threadripper Pro 3995WX. Threadripper can also do that, but it's still more a hybrid between a workstation and a desktop PC. So it lacks some crucial features that Threadripper Pro has, and also some expandability options, which we will discuss about later in the video. Next, we have RAM and memory channels. And this is a limitation because of desktop CPUs and their motherboards. Now, consumer motherboards from both the blue and red team comes with 4 slots and they run in a dual channel configuration. With Threadripper, you have 8 slots and they run in a quad channel configuration. But with Threadripper Pro, you have 8 slots also, but they run in an 8 channel configuration. Also, when it comes to the max RAM capacity on desktops, you're gonna hit the ceiling at 128GB, but with workstation platforms like Threadripper Pro, the sky is the limit because you can go up to a whopping 2TB.
Shane, 2TB is ridiculous, why would you need that? 128GB is more than enough, I only have 8GB and I'm fine.
Okay, now 128GB of RAM might seem like a lot to you, even if you're doing YouTube, but if you're dealing with more serious workloads like in the movie industry and you're dealing with very heavy codecs from cameras like RED and RE at high resolutions like 8K, 12K and all that stuff, then 128GB is actually a joke. Number 3. PCIe lanes. PCIe lanes are used as an extremely fast traffic path that connects devices directly to your CPU, like a highway. And workstations in the creative field choose PCIe lanes for breakfast. For example, a desktop PC with Ryzen's current 5000 series of CPUs has 24 PCIe lanes. 16 of these lanes are used for your GPU, like the Nvidia RTX 3080 or AMD's Radeon RX 6900 XT. Four of those lanes are used for your M.2 PCIe NVMe storage drive, and that leaves you with four more lanes for maybe a secondary M.2 NVMe storage. And depending on which motherboard chipset you get, with the same desktop CPU, you'll have access to more or less PCIe lanes for things like SATA, USB and such. Take a close look at this chart for a better idea. This is a comparison between the X570, B550 and A520 chipsets that are all compatible with the Ryzen 5000 series CPUs. This lane limitation also restricts the number of physical slots that you have on desktop motherboards for you to plug in your devices. But Shane, my motherboard has 3 PCIe slots and 3 M.2 slots. Yes, most motherboards these days have more than one PCIe slot, but other than the main PCIe slot on top that runs on full speed, the other ones below are actually having their data traffic directed towards the motherboard's chipset and not directly straight on the highway to the CPU. It's like having a rest stop on the highway where people go there and then rest and also eat MacD. Got detour, confirm got delay lah. Like that also don't know meh. Your ma the notice I teach you long. What happens if you plug in more than one GPU into your desktop motherboard? While not all, but most motherboards these days will allow you to do that, when you plug in more than one GPU into your motherboard, both of those GPUs will not be running at the full 16 lane speed that is available if you plug in just one GPU. They'll be running at X8. Which means that you're not getting your money's worth, huh? It's like you buy a Ferrari, but then you run it at 50 km per hour. In summary, to get optimum performance from a multi-GPU setup, workstations are better for that, okay? Just for reference, Threadripper, which is a hybrid between workstation and desktop PCs, only has 64 PCIe lanes, but Threadripper Pro has doubled that at 128 PCIe lanes. Number 4, we have the ability to upgrade or expand. With a higher ceiling for CPU cores, RAM, as well as PCIe lanes, workstations are better suited for creative professionals that deal with heavier workloads, regardless what stage of your career you are at, because you can always just keep on upgrading. Now, for quite some time, the Blue Team was our only option with their high-end desktop or HEDT platform, but then AMD released Threadripper, which is a hybrid between a desktop and workstation, and then they have now released a proper workstation platform, which is Threadripper Pro. Now I'm going to leave Mike to actually explain to us everything you need to know about Threadripper Pro from a workstation function standpoint, as well as expandability. Psst. Honestly, I'm just curious to see what kind of monstrosity he has built in his studio.
So let's take a look at one of the best workstation class motherboards and CPUs available on the market today. This system that I have here at my test bench is the Asus Pro WS-WRX80E Sage SE Wi-Fi motherboard, and I have two RTX 3080s installed, as well as Asus Hyper M.2 16X Gen 4 RAID card with 4 NVMe drives. All these devices that are plugged in are using a fraction of the 128 PCIe lanes available. This allows every component to run at lightning fast speeds and communicate directly with a 32-core Ryzen Threadripper Pro. This is a 3975WX CPU in this system. So you're also gonna need a lot of drive space, you know, 10 to 20 or even 30 gigabytes of drive space. And this is where this Asus Hyper M.2 RAID card comes in. You can install 4 NVMe drives across that and get 32 gigabytes a second that is transferring data directly to the GPU and CPU at lightning fast speeds. So let's take a look at how DaVinci's Resolve works with all this hardware that we have installed on this Threadripper Pro system. So unlike Premiere Pro, DaVinci's Resolve can support multiple GPUs and harness all the power that's available in these RTX graphic cards. So here I have DaVinci's Resolve open and I've just downloaded some test RED footage, some 8K RED footage off the internet. And the most important thing when you're doing video editing is being able to smoothly play back your video and jump around on your timeline. And you can see here that we can scroll and jump around and it's playing back extremely smooth. And if we play through, that's 8K footage, not a frame being dropped. You can see that over here. And to make it even more complicated is I threw some Blackmagic 4K footage on top. So if you have a hardware monitor, you can open that up and you can see that the CPUs are actually running at quite a high percent, and that's because the Blackmagic footage is a CPU codec, so it's using the CPU to decode it. And then you'll notice down here under the GPU, I'm running at 100% utilization. The red footage is a GPU codec. So in this case, we have mixed media on the timeline, and they're both playing back extremely smooth, and we still have a little bit of resources left on the computer. Unfortunately, this is DaVinci's Resolve, the free version, and it doesn't support multiple GPUs. So if I did have the studio version, I would be able to play back, you know, multiple streams of, you know, red footage, or use the second or even a third GPU to do heavy, you know, compute tasks like denoising. So I've swapped out the RTX 3080s for three RTX 3090s. So let's take a look at two different 3D workflows. If you're doing a lot of CPU rendering, you're gonna need something with a lot of CPU cores, like a 32 or 64 core Threadripper Pro. Unless you're doing GPU rendering with something like V-Ray, Redshift, or Octane, those can then utilize multiple GPUs in a system to do all the rendering tasks. I would not recommend the Threadripper Pro for any kind of 3D modeling or animation work. You're better off sticking with the desktop CPU because those systems have a higher single core clock speed. And when you're interacting with Maya or Blender, any of the 3D programs, it's actually only using one core. But if you're doing rendering and lighting work, that requires as many cores as it can to process those types of projects. The more cores and the faster the cores, the faster you're gonna render. And as you can see here, we're literally utilizing all 32 cores and 32 threads at 100%. And this test is complete at about 40,000 points. And in the Cinebench scale, that is extremely high. So now let's check out some GPU rendering with the three RTX 3090s. I have Blender open with the standard BMW scene. And if we come into preferences, we're just gonna try out, see how long it takes to render on one GPU first. So if you're building a GPU rendering system, you don't need a lot of cores. You could use like a 12 core Threadripper and even 64 gigs of RAM. The important part is getting the 128 lanes of PCIe so that you can plug in all of the GPUs. And in this case, you could actually plug in the fourth one right down here. I just don't have enough power in my power supply. That render completed in about 20 seconds. So let's see actually how long it takes to render out with three RTX 3090s. So we'll turn these two back on. Render, and that's complete in about 8 seconds. So it did decrease the time quite a bit, but let's take a look at one more Blender scene. We'll look at the standard classroom scene. So we got the classroom scene opened up here, and we're just gonna hit render on the three RTX 3090s. And we'll take a look at the hardware monitor. And as you can see, it's rendering extremely fast, and we have almost all three GPUs are running at 100%. Where the CPUs are doing very little. So that's one of the best benefits about this ASUS Sage WRX80 motherboard is that it's got 7 full PCIe slots at 16x each. And the Threadripper Pro with 128 lanes of PCIe connectivity, it makes rendering something like this out extremely fast. And this render finished in about 20 seconds. So it does take about 2.5 minutes to render across CPUs, even when you're using 32 cores.
Thanks, mate. Huge shout out to Mike for dropping them nuggets of wisdom on the differences between workstation and desktop. Also, if you want to see a more technical analysis of the differences between a workstation and desktop PC, feel free to go to his channel because he made another video that's more like geeky and nerdy in case you're a nerd. I hope you learned something today. If you thought this video is awesome, don't forget to give it a like and share, and also leave a comment down below if you have any more questions regarding, well, workstations. And also don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell to not miss out on any content from us. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Instagram to see more shenanigans from the Mob House crew. And if you want to bring things to the next level and get in a more intimate relationship with me, feel free to join our supporter program so that you can join our Discord and then chat with me, ask me questions about being a content creator or a gamer or whatever lah, okay? And I will see you in the next one.